is Children Education Elements. Before directly going to my video, let me tell you, if you are not yet subscribed, please subscribe my channel so that you will get all my videos as I put into the YouTube. So without further ado, let us go to the topic, that is your Children Education Elements. Who all are eligible for this and what are the criteria for this? How much amount you will get per child? So these are the things we are going to discuss in detail today. So every central government employee is eligible for Children Education Allowance for the eldest two surviving children. Only for two eldest children you can claim this CEA. But if the second child birth is a twin birth or a multiple birth, then you can claim CEA for all the children in the second birth also. And another thing is, if a child is born soon after the failure of sterilization surgery, for the first child born in such case is also eligible for CEA. In addition to central government employees, any central government employee who is deputed to state government service can also avail this Children Education Allowance, which is shortly known as CEA. Also, any state government employee who is deputed to central government can also avail this facility. And what are the other personnels? Who are the other personnels can avail this facility? One is the industrial establishment personnels. Those who are working in industrial units can also avail this. Also, personnels who are deputed for foreign service can avail this. Defense civilians who are paid from defense estimates can also avail this Children Education Allowance. And if the husband and wife both are employed in central government or in the above mentioned category, what to do? Only one can claim the Children Education Allowance. So they can decide themselves who is going to claim this. And while putting the request for CEA, they can put a joint declaration stating that so and so personnel is only claiming the CEA. The other person, the spouse, is not claiming the CEA. And what are the other documents required for claiming CEA? So if you have a child and who is studying in a particular institution, so you can just get a report from the head of the institution stating that so and so student is studied in the particular institution for the last academic year. So this will be a relevant document for claiming CEA. And in addition to this document, in special cases, for example, in the present case of pandemic, corona pandemic, sometimes we are not able to get such document from the head of department. Then what to do? You can even put up the e-receipt of the tuition fee paid for the entire academic year as a proof for your CEA claim. Also, the normal receipt which you paid fees for the entire academic year is also a valid document for claiming CEA. And what are the age limit for, or which students will get the CEA? Any child, irrespective of the minimum age limit, from nursery to 12th standard can claim this CEA. So nursery includes your kindergarten, LKG, anything. But only thing is that any institution which is aided by government is only acceptable for CEA claim. So remember that if you want to claim your CEA for your children, they should study in government aided institution. Yes, there are exemptions. If you have a mentally challenged or physically challenged child, in that case, for getting special training, even you can go to unaided institution, and that reimbursement is also can be come under Children Education Allowance. And how much is the amount? So 27,000 per child per year is the present amount for normal children. And for Divyang children, or you can say disabled children, it is exactly the double. That is 54,000 per child per year is the rate for Divyang children. Okay, then what is the upper age limit for claiming CEA? So normally for normal children, it is up to 12th standard or 20 years is the age limit. In case of mentally or physically challenged children, it can be extended up to 22 years. Okay, and another important thing is that if a child fails in a particular class and continue to be in the same class for next year also, Still, he can claim the children education allowance. Even for correspondence course or distant education courses can come under children education allowance. And this children education allowance can be claimed even during the leave of the employee. And if an employee retires while the child is in a particular academic year, he will continue to get the CEA till such time the child completes that particular academic year. And it is same in case of superannuation or retirement. That is, he can claim this CEA for the particular academic year in which the student or the child is continuing. Okay. So, when will the rate hike? That, as I said, 27,000 per child per year is the current rate. So, when will a hike occur? If the DA is increased by 50% of the present 50% of your basic pay, then automatically the children education allowance CEA will also increase by 25%. Okay, and during only thing is during dias known you cannot claim this CEA. So these are the major things about CEA. Every central government employee or any deputation person and industrial person and defense civilians, also those who are deputed for foreign service, can claim this CEA. Also, it is 27,000 per year per child is normal rate and 54,000 for Divyang children. It is extended for 22 years for such children. Normal upper age limit is 20 years. So, these are the major things of CEA. I hope you like my video. Please share it, like it and subscribe. Thank you.